Teachers and other employees of Colegio de San Lorenzo also on the hunt for new jobs. One school official says their last day would be on September 20th. He adds they have already been given a computation of their separation pay.
Kami po ay nagsisimula na rin naman po maghanap ng aming mga bagong trabaho. Nagpapasalamat po kami sa mga iba't ibang paaralan na bumibisita rito sa amin araw-araw. At kinakausap po kami mga empleyado kasama ng mga estudyante. Marami po sa kanila willing kaming i-absorb sa kanilang mga eskwelahan.
The Education Department says it was assured by Colegio de San Lorenzo it will help affected students find new schools. DepEd spokesperson Michael Poa says some schools have agreed to defer collecting fees until a refund of tuition is issued to students. He adds the issuance of transfer credentials will be prioritized.
Bago namin sila papayagang tuluyang magsara, kailangan po ma-process at ma-issue nila lahat ng transfer credentials. Kami naman, especially yung grade 11 and 12, eh, siyempre ka-graduate din po yung mga yan. So, very important na mailipat sila kasi sayang po yung oras. So, ito naman pong themes, and I'm sure the other schools also, although we haven't really coordinated closely with the other schools. Pero ito pong themes, they're willing to absorb yung grade 11 and 12, which is very good para po masiguradong makagraduate po ang ating mga learners.
Some students of the shuttered Colegio de San Lorenzo in Quezon City have received a tuition refund. The challenge now is finding a different school to take them in. For fourth-year film major Gerald Banda, while many schools have opened their doors for displaced students, none of them have the same program he has been taking. He's also worried he would not be able to afford studying in other universities.
Yun din po yung isa sa naging stressors namin as students. Kasi dahil nga sa San Lo, yun yung pinili namin kasi bukod sa quality naman po education, mura siya. Ngayon, dahil nga po lilipat kami, may chance na mas dumoble o triple pa yung gastos namin. Yung mga Latin honors, yung mga kaklase ko po kasi nalagaan nila yung grade nila for 3 years. Ngayon po, pag lumipat sila, wala na po silang chance na ma-honor kasi po dahil po need na residency para ma-acquire mo po yung Latin honors.
The Education Department says 27 million students have so far enrolled for the new school year. That's 96% of the agency's target. DepEd spokesperson Michael Paula assures parents health measures are in place to keep learners safe from COVID-19.
Out of 1,945,000, meron po tayong 921,925 teaching and non-teaching personnel na bakunado na. Meron na pong second dose. So that makes up for 92.11% of our teaching and non-teaching staff. We have downloaded 3.7 billion nationwide as a supplemental MOOE for the schools. Ito po ay para masigurado na kumpleto sila sa mga kagamitan, especially for the minimum health and safety standards to be observed, tulad ng mga alcohol. We are also requiring our schools na meron tayong stock ng mga face mask, at tumutulong naman po yung LGU dyan sa pagsusupply rin sa ating mga schools ng mga face mask.
Teachers are more than ready for the resumption of limited face-to-face classes, but the Education Department is not. That's the observation of the group Action and Solidarity for the Empowerment of Teachers. On top of their concerns, the protection of teachers from COVID. The group says they are being asked to sign waivers, stating the DepEd has no liabilities even if they contract the virus. They're now appealing for COVID hazard pay.
Kami po sa anilang kaguruan ay handang-handa na po. Ang hindi po handa ay ang DepEd. Sa totoo lang po, hindi po handa ang DepEd sa pasukang ito. Po, meron kami hinihingi sa ating IBP Sara na hazard pay. COVID hazard pay po ang nilalaban po natin dyan na maibigay sa mga teacher. Bilang karampantang punas para po sa ating mga teacher na may infect ng virus. Pinagpapasa po kami ng mga dokumento. Sana nga lang po, hindi lang yun puro dokumento. Bigyan din nila ng aksyon.